Okay, so you started spending some money on marketing. You've made a few tweaks here and there, but all of a sudden you ask yourself, what's next? What creative should you create? What audiences seem interested in your product or services? What keywords are people converting on your website from? And these are all the right questions. But in order to answer them, you're going to need, yes, you guessed it, some marketing data analysis. In this video, I'm going to explain what marketing data analysis is, what types of data you need to be aware of when doing analysis, types of marketing data analysis, common challenges when doing marketing data analysis, and much, much more. So, if you're a marketer, stick around for a deep dive into my favorite topic. My favorite topic? Yeah, maybe it is my favorite topic. I mean, we are a marketing data company after all, right? Understanding the data universe. First things first, there are three types of marketing data that you need to be working with and need to understand. First party data, this is data collected directly from your customers and interactions. First party data is highly reliable and relevant, offering deep insights into your audience's preferences and behaviors. Second party data, this is someone else's first party data shared with you, usually through partnerships. Third party data, gathered by external organizations from various sources, third-party data offers broad market insights and can help identify new customer segments. However, it may lack the precision and relevance of first-party data and comes with more significant privacy considerations. Now, this is most relevant when thinking about cookies. If you aren't up to speed on cookies, that's A-OK, but I recommend watching our video all about cookies. But for the purposes of this video, cookies are a way to collect data, and with all the recent changes around the deprecation of third-party cookies, it's important you know which data you're working with. Setting yourself up to do marketing data analysis. Before I explain some more advanced marketing analysis, let's talk about how you can walk before you can run. The most important first thing to do as a marketer is create a reliable automated data pipeline that brings all of the data you have available into one place. Then, you need to ensure that the data you have is clean and correct so you can create some basic dashboards or reports to have, at the very least, a basic overview. This enables you to report on your numbers and answer basic questions about your marketing efforts when they inevitably come from, well, management. Having all of your data accessible in one place is also makes it easier for you to do more advanced marketing data analysis on an ad hoc basis as questions come up, without having to make requests to data teams and wait for tickets to be resolved. Advanced analytical techniques. Which is a nice segue into a couple of examples of advanced analytics techniques. Number one, customer segmentation. This involves dividing your business's customer base into groups of individuals with similar characteristics or behaviors to tailor marketing strategies more effectively. But in order to apply customer segmentation, you first have to analyze your customer base to understand how you'll segment them and what you intend to do with that segmentation. Think about the different segments you could create, then ask yourself, if I had these buckets, what would I do differently for each group? Different creatives, different landing pages, different messaging, different keywords, different products or services. You get the idea. Number two, predictive analytics. This uses historical data and statistical algorithms to forecast future behaviors, trends, and outcomes, helping businesses anticipate customer needs and make proactive decisions. What I will say is that predictive analytics is like the Holy Grail. If you can do some form of reliable predictive analytics, then you're in the top 1%. So don't pressure yourself too much in this particular area, but if you do get there, good for you. Number three, sentiment analysis. Often applied in social media monitoring and customer feedback, this assesses the emotional tone behind textual data to understand consumer attitudes, opinions, and emotion towards a brand or product. Now, I have mixed feelings about sentiment analysis. In my opinion, it's only really useful for the biggest of the biggest global brands, and if you're not Coca-Cola or Adidas, I don't think it's worth the compute power. Number four, customer lifetime value prediction, which estimates the total revenue a business can expect from a single customer account throughout their relationship, enabling companies to identify high-value customers, and allocate marketing resources efficiently. I'm not going to explain this one in tons of detail, but if you're interested, I do have a full video on customer lifetime value, so check that one out because it is really good to know. Leveraging data for strategic decision-making. Strategy. We all need to be strategic about what we do because otherwise, well, what are we doing? Just doing stuff and hoping it works out? Let's be real, it's 2024 and your marketing strategy needs to be informed by data. Note how I said informed by data, because data cannot actually make decisions. It can't actually be your conviction, but the more you know, the more conviction you can build around your strategy. Marketing data analysis can help tell you how you can spend your marketing dollars more efficiently, and there are four key areas you need to be able to turn to data to aid in your decision making. Targeting, personalization, channel optimization, and budget allocation. For targeting, you need to understand who buys your product or service so you can find more of them out there and target them with your marketing. Personalization then is about analyzing what resonates with your target audience. For example, what creatives perform the best? What content pieces have the most conversions? What organic social posts have the most reach and engagement, etc., etc. Channel optimization is about evaluating each channel's effectiveness in terms of reaching your target audience, engaging them, and driving conversions. You need to know what role each channel plays in the customer journey and how to get the most out of each channel. Budget allocation requires you to have a good top-level overview of your marketing spend by channel, then lean into that channel mix to figure out how to distribute that spend across your channels. And my big tip here is don't forget about creative costs. Paid ads and content are great, but they're only as good as what you put into them. So if you put subpar creatives into it, you'll get subpar performance out. So be sure to allocate budget for creatives too. Tools and technologies powering data analysis. Naturally, you can't do marketing data analysis without tools. What's any worker without their tools? I mentioned earlier that the first thing a marketer needs to be able to do is create a reliable data pipeline, get all of their data into one place, and create basic automated reports. You need tools for all of this, and I will add one more to the list, which is have a playground where you can analyze your data. There are two common ways to achieve everything on this list. One is referred to as the modern data stack. The other is out-of-the-box software. Many companies do opt for the modern data stack, but this can be costly to build and maintain, requiring a ton of developer and engineering time. Alternatively, you can opt for vertical software that solves these challenges out of the box for you. Funnel happens to be just one of those tools. Using Funnel, you can achieve 1, 2, and 3 with just a few clicks. And for number 4, you even have options for where you want that playground to be. You can either explore the data in our Google Sheets-like Data Explorer, or you can simply choose a few fields and actually send them to a Google Sheet to slice and dice however you want. Or if you're a data warehouse user, you can always export years of transformed historical data to a data warehouse and do your analysis there. There are, of course, alternatives, especially in the data ingestion area, but no platform offers the depth and reliability of connectors because it turns out those APIs can actually be a little tricky to build and maintain. Things to watch out for when doing analysis. Getting started with data analysis is one thing, but it's a whole different ballgame to be good at marketing data analysis. So, to help you avoid tripping up, and because I love a list in my videos, I've got 3 things for you to keep in mind. Number 1, double check your numbers before you present an analysis. The amount of times I've just done a quick double check before my numbers go into a presentation or get sent to a manager and realized, actually, that number is wrong. Number 2, is the data you're looking at the same as what someone else is looking at? Data silos are super common in organizations, and you need to make sure that the data points you know are being presented by other people or teams are the same, and you're not presenting 2 different numbers and calling them the same thing. Number 3, take care when presenting your numbers. You might think that the analysis is the hard part and the presentation is the easy part, but how you present your numbers really affects the impact that they will have. So be sure to follow data visualization best practices. And you guessed it, I have a video on that topic too. So check that one out. Conclusion and call to action. Okay, so let me just recap what you absolutely need to remember before getting started with marketing data analysis. You need good, reliable, and convenient data in order to actually do analysis. Marketing data analysis can and should inform your marketing strategy. You can't do marketing in 2024 without doing some kind of data analysis. Tools are essential for doing marketing data analysis. And finally, remember, marketing data analysis isn't just about numbers. It's about unlocking the story behind your marketing efforts. Take your numbers, contextualize them, and discover the stories they tell. If you like this video, please like and subscribe, or you'll get more videos about digital marketing, marketing data best practices, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to make yourself a better marketer.